In this video, you'll see how to synchronize AWS Config Aggregator resources into the ServiceNow CMDB. With the AWS Service Management Connector for ServiceNow, you can integrate an AWS Config Aggregator and have near real-time visibility of AWS resources in ServiceNow, helping to facilitate incident and change management. For the purposes of this example, we've already configured the AWS Service Management Connector in ServiceNow. To get started, let's find the AWS account we've created in ServiceNow. This is our main AWS account. We've already enabled integration with AWS Config. We have also associated this integration with the region of our AWS account. Next, let's navigate to the AWS Config aggregator we've already configured in our AWS environment. This aggregator collects AWS Config data from four accounts. Let's take a closer look. These are the regions associated with the four accounts. Let's take a look at the resource inventory. We have more than 2,000 resources across our four accounts, including 70 Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or Amazon EC2, instances. Let's view these resources. Let's filter this data to show only EC2 instances. Next, let's filter for EC2 security groups. As you can see, the security groups are aggregated here as well. Next, let's create an aggregator in ServiceNow to synchronize these resources. First, we'll copy the name of the aggregator in AWS Config. Next, we'll go to ServiceNow and create a new aggregator for AWS Config. We'll paste in the name of the aggregator and select the relevant AWS account and region. This newly created aggregator will begin synchronizing the data from AWS Config into ServiceNow. AWS Service Management Connector schedules a job to run every 31 minutes to enable near real-time updates from AWS into ServiceNow. Let's find that job and execute it manually. Next, let's review our EC2 instances in ServiceNow to make sure the job we just executed has started bringing in data. A number of EC2 instances associated with our AWS accounts are listed here. Let's add a column for the correlation ID, which will provide us with more information about which account and region each resource belongs to. Now we can see the type, AWS resource ID, and region of each resource. Let's drill down into one of these EC2 instances to see its metadata. We can use the dependency view to visualize the upstream and downstream relationships for this EC2 instance. Let's reduce the levels down to 1 so we can only see the most direct relationships. Next, let's make sure all the security groups were synchronized as well. These security groups were synchronized from our AWS Config aggregator into our ServiceNow CMDB. Let's go back to AWS Config to confirm the number of resources coming from our Config aggregator into ServiceNow. We should have 98 EC2 security groups discoverable in ServiceNow. Next, let's create a new EC2 instance within the account and see if it's captured in ServiceNow. We currently have 2 EC2 instances running. Let's terminate one of them. Now we'll launch a new instance. We now have 1 terminated instance, 1 that's running, and 1 that's still initializing. Let's go back to ServiceNow and run the scheduled job again. Executing this job should bring the updates we just performed into the ServiceNow CMDB. let's check the EC2 instances to confirm that the changes are reflected. As expected, the terminated instance was discovered. Let's add a status column to the view. The terminated EC2 instance has a status of retired. Next, to help us find the newly created instance, let's copy its instance ID from the AWS Config console. Let's see if we can find this ID in ServiceNow. Here's the instance we created. You've just seen how to synchronize AWS Config Aggregator resources into the ServiceNow CMDB. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.